Artwork for a JRPG is pretty important to me. I don't know about you guys, but me personally, I'm kind of a visual creature when it comes to games. If the game has a nice art style, it has my curiosity. But if and only if it has gameplay that I like, can a game ever have my full attention? For JRPGs, one of the first things we see are character designs, and there are a ton of character designers for JRPGs that I really like. And I'm not one to question or even care about if the design is realistic or if that type of body is even possible. I just like what I like. So here I am with 5 JRPG character designers I can't get enough of. Before I begin, be sure to hit that like button if you enjoyed this video and leave a comment. Also, I'm probably going to butcher the names of some of these artists. And you know what? I don't give a fuck. Let's go. Tahikito Harada. Harada is best known for his artwork in the Disgaea series. At first, I didn't like his style all that much. When it came to earlier works in games like Phantom Brave and Makai Kingdom and Disgaea 1, I just found his style unappealing. It wasn't until Disgaea 3 that I started to really notice that his style was getting more lively, colorful, and his characters have really big eyes. I really like Almaz's simple design and Sapphire's cute look. Now, in the modern day, I feel his design is fun, cartoony almost, and a little bit out there sometimes, but he has a very distinct style that you can spot from a mile away. Harada is almost unanimous with Disgaea at this point. I can't picture anyone else doing the character designs for Disgaea. If they did, I don't know if I want to play the game. Just kidding, if the gameplay is still Disgaea, I could care less about the character designs. But it really does add a nice little flair to the game when I like the art style. His art in the actual game translates well with all the crazy and over-the-top attacks that Disgaea has and with the character sprites. And my favorite character from him has got to be Zeta. He's got this cool final boss look that looks badass and intimidating all at the same time. Honjo Raita. Before I begin talking about this particular artist, let me just get this out the way right now. Search this artist at your own risk. You have been warned. He's not exactly safe for work. Okay, Raita is not a character designer you look to for realism. His style is rather wild. The anatomy on his characters can be a little bit out there, and I'm sure most of his female characters might suffer from back problems. But I don't play JRPGs or any video game for that matter for realism. So I don't care at all if his character's chest size might be 2 times bigger than her head. That might be something you personally care for, but for me, hell, make him 4 times bigger than her head. I don't give a damn. So let's continue. I first encountered Raita's unique brand of art when playing the Valkyria Chronicles games, more specifically Valkyria Chronicles 2. Because the series got ported to the PSP, the graphics of the game were downgraded, so the developers went with a more 2D art visual novel cutscenes that showcased the character designs more. At the time of Valkyria Chronicles 2 release, I didn't know who the artist was until I was at an anime convention and saw an art book for Valkyria Chronicles 2 for the first time. And I decided to search for more stuff online and, as I said earlier, search this artist at your own risk. In Valkyria Chronicles games, I like his soft yet sharp designs. I think he's really good at drawing expressions as well. He's also done work for Fate Grand Order, a mobile game which I play, and you know what, let me just plug my current squad right now. My favorite designs from him are easily Severia from Valkyria Chronicles 1 and Rhea from Valkyria Chronicles 3. Suzuhito Yasuda. If I wanted to create a JRPG set in the current world, I would want Yasuda at the helm for my character design. Clean, sharp, crisp, and modern are the words I would use to describe his brand of art. I best know him for his work in the Shin Megami Tensei Devil Survivor games. Devil Survivor 1 and 2 are remarkable tactical RPGs. With Devil Survivor 1 breaching my top 5 JRPGs of all time still, and what helped land it on air was the character designs. But now that I think about it, God, I wish there was a Devil Survivor 3 coming out. But I doubt that's even in the realm of possibility at this point. His character designs didn't translate translate too well in-game when battles took place, but during the cutscenes with the sort of visual novel setup, it wasn't half bad. He's also had his art in the Digimon Cyber Sleuth games, which I dabbled in for a little bit and thought they were pretty good RPGs. His character designs actually translated well here to the in-game graphics of Cyber Sleuth. The character's models closely resembled his art, so that's a major plus. Outside of games, he has done work in character designs for manga like Durarara and Danmachi. I had no idea until I was doing research for this video that he was the character designer behind Danmachi, or rather, is it wrong to pick up girls in the dungeon? Which now explains why I could never fully hate Hestia, even though I never liked her at first. My favorite character design from him would have to be Fumi from Devil Survivor 2. Tetsuya Nomura. Tetsuya Nomura? Nomura? The dude that took forever to get out Kingdom Hearts 3? The dude that had to drop Final Fantasy 15 mid-development? The dude that wanted to turn Final Fantasy 15 into a musical? The dude that has a zippers and belt fetish? Nomura? Yes, Tetsuya Nomura. I think we can all agree that Nomura can't get a game out in a timely fashion to save his life, but we can all probably agree that his artwork is pretty freaking awesome. I mean, just look at this cover for Kingdom Hearts 3. This has got to be the most badass, yet emotionally charged cover I have ever seen for a game. His art is really just hands down on the cool side. Well, of course, his signature long, colorful, sharp hair that can kill someone, huge swords that can probably weigh 10 times more than the person wielding them, and of course, the belts and zippers. I think he's toned down on the zippers a little bit. Kinda. My favorite designs from him have got to be Cloud and Tifa. George Kematami. I love Kematami's art. This man can do no wrong. I could never pass up a chance to play a game that features his art, so I'm pretty much playing every VanillaWare game under the sun. I first encountered his art in Oldenspear on PS2, and I have been in love with his works ever since. Like, I will literally play any game that has his art regardless of the type of game it is, or I'm willing to give it a shot at the very least. I played most of his games, Marsama the Demon Blade, Oldenspear, Dragon's Crown, and even the not localized Grand Knight's History. His art translates incredibly well to the in-game graphics. I love that his character designs can jump off his canvas to the game, especially the character sprites. His style is a little bit over the top when it comes to some of his female character designs, like the Amazon and Sorceress from Dragon's Crown. Even his normal designs look a little bit crazy from time to time, but I still like them all. And it should be noted that he deliberately exaggerated and cartoonified the designs for Dragon's Crown to avoid it being labeled as a generic fantasy. I thank him for that because I might love Dragon's Crown because he decided to make his designs really out there. My favorite character designs for him has got to be Gwendolyn and Velvet in Oldenspear and the aforementioned Amazon and Sorceress in Dragon's Crown. Now, if we can just get 13 Sentinels Aegis Rim to come out, that would be great because the game was announced in 2015 and it's 2019 and, you know, we barely got a demo for the game, so, you know, but I guess you can't rush perfection. I don't want him to rush. All I'm saying is take your time, dude, but hurry up. Hashtag don't be like Nomura. So there you have it, 5 JRPG character designers I love. Now there is way more than 5 for me, but I really wanted to narrow it down to only 5. I want to know exactly if you care about artists and character designers in your games. I know for me it adds a nice little layer of enjoyment if I love the art style. Remember to hit that like button if you enjoyed this video, and of course subscribe if you want to see more. I'll catch you guys in the next video. Peace.